Hi folks, and welcome to what is another catch-up, because things have been going on, and yeah, where do I even start? Still, as always, play has been a bit bitty, due to various factors in life, and but stuff's been happening, things have been going on. Part of it is that I've also been looking at what Brian J has been doing in his base. And, yeah, I've made a few alterations here, some through necessity. And, where are we? Yeah, there's been a few changes around here. I've muted the glowstone by dark glass. I did try some of the shroom lights, but the problem is, I mean, if you've got glow light, glowstone, you can open a chest. If you've got shroom light above it, you can't. So my intention of replacing everything with shroom light went out the window. I don't know if you've seen the open area, but the chests have changed. there were some double chests around that corner which needed to be sorted out, and some of them have come in here, along with a chest that is for my dangerous area mining equipment. So if I'm doing something dangerous, I don't have to risk my normal set of armor. Because I have been doing a few things. There are changes with this system, which we will come to in a minute. But as you can see, this is now a lot more full with a few things. I've brought some things down, even when it comes down to the stairs, of which there were more than a double chest worth. I've actually used some stairs as fuel for a few things. So I got rid of some of the wood stairs by burning them and altered these shelves, so there's still another three sets of double shelves, double chests rather, which are ready to be filled. And one thing that Brian did was use these fruits as vines and in his base to cover some areas, and I've done exactly that here. Great idea. I mean, I'm good at technical stuff, but I'm not very good at design, so I have to borrow from other people. And that's how it goes around. So if you go in here, I actually moved all this section, and you can see I've got the vibe going on in here. It's not very easy to get a lot of things done, and I've also done that slightly odd chest configuration just to make it look interesting. So there's definitely a vibe going on in here. But yeah, I can't see it staying like this. I don't know. You can't bring things down because the signs get in the way of things growing down blocks. So it's not that straightforward. It's yet to develop. In here, there is now a door. And that door takes you in the back for a lot of chests that otherwise I couldn't reach, which is badly needed. And it was badly needed, and you see somehow the extra storage, the at least two double chests and a couple of extra hoppers worth of storage that the bottom chests have got. Because I did a kelp thing, and I had to catch up. And I've also altered pretty much everything down here. Now, I've still got to do a few alterations to the furnace, which we'll do now. Multiples of 2.5 stacks, that is what's supposed to go in. And why that is because you know you've got a few different things here. You've got the usual furnace, you've got the smoker, and you've got the blast furnace. Now, coal will do 8 items. Blaze rods will do 12. Kelp block, however, will do 20. And that is regardless of which of these furnaces you use. The upside is that the smoker and the blast furnace are twice as fast as the standard furnace for certain items, but you get the same out of them that you put in. Now we have the speed furnace downstairs. And I'm going to take some stuff out of here now, in fact. Some of this stuff just isn't needed anymore. Now I was feeding certain things through the smoker. For the ease of various bits and pieces. I can get rid of that, I can get rid of that and that. And then take this out. What I was doing was feeding kelp through the smoker. I can actually put one of those back. I can't because I haven't picked them up. Oh, of course, that's what's happened. We'll put the dried kelp in. These are Cookie Monster cookies. Those are Cookie Monster cookies, quite a few Cookie Monster cookies. What I should hopefully have picked up were these, but it doesn't look like I have. And that was the mechanism. Basically, if kelp came down here or something else, then they would be diverted. Why was that diverted? Because I needed extra space and that was getting in the way. Okay, that made sense. But yeah, so I need another one of those composters to put on top of there. But what was happening, and I'm going to need some black carpet. So what was happening was I was deliberately feeding kelp into the smoker. And then further into... so that it could go faster, basically. And I was doing that via another machine up here as well. There was a lot of kelp to cook, and I wasn't cooking it quickly enough, so I set up another cooker. Do I have everything I need? No, I don't, in fact. So... let's put some of this stuff away, at least. Workstations. There aren't any workstations. These are Cookie Monster cookies, so they need to go away safe. We have some mechs and redstone here to get rid of. Oh, there is a smoker. There's the smoker, workstation smoker. That's white concrete. We have a concrete here somewhere. And we'll put these into the sorting system. More redstone. And some chests. Eventually some stuff will come in there, I have no doubt. What I did was I set up another large section of smokers up here. And the theory was sound. If I set up more, I can do more quicker. And then it inevitably came to the maths. And it worked out that what these cookers do not alter is the speed at which things are done. Sorry, well, by the way, I mean speed that things are done. What I mean is... okay, those are those which we need. Basically, the amount of fuel didn't change. So if the amount of fuel is not changing, it doesn't matter which unit I actually use to do them with. Is the long story short. So I might as well use the speed furnace. And I came to some other alterations as well. Is concrete here, or did I put it somewhere else? Is it there? No. I've got to get used to where I've put stuff now. Oh yeah, there it is. Concrete. I need some black carpet. I'll take you through the... Is there any black carpet in here? Yes, there is. take you through the maths. Three primary fuels. Coal, which is getting more difficult to source. Blaze rods, which do require... I've gone in completely the wrong direction. Blaze rods, which require having some argy-bargy with some blazes, which we get as standard. Oh, I wanted a composter. That's what should be waiting somewhere. There should be waiting that hopper. No. There? No. Are they waiting there? No. So if they're not waiting anywhere up there, then where do they go? They must have gone into the systems, which means they must be somewhere. They should either be in the overflow, which they're not yet, or something's waiting up there. We can put the car bit back. So there's no real point in separating things out to go into a smoker when it's just going to go slower anyway. I mean, by it's an 8 furnace speed furnace, you know. A smoker is only twice as fast as a standard furnace, so using the speed furnace, I'm still going to be 4 times as fast. And as long as I'm using dried kelp block, you'll note this used to be coal, it is now dried kelp block, feeding the system. Blaze rods are no longer a secondary feed, and coal is now up here on its own. I had made some coal and charcoal to fire the system, or made some charcoal to fire the system. I thought, you know what, this is bonkers. Dried kelp block, I've got 4 dried kelp machines, which we'll take a look at in a minute. Once I've actually found out where the heck this this stray stuff has gone, i.e. the composters. So where the hell are the composters? I've got a feeling that the large amount of dried kelp block I just put in the system is knackering things. It's probably up there somewhere. I can't actually get a hold of it. I have to do something about that. That it just made it... How many dried kelp do we have? Ooh, plenty. We'll wait until that's more full, and then we'll take advantage of it. I want to know where the composters have ended up. They haven't ended up in one of the odd ones, so they must still be somewhere. Let's get some... Where are they? Scaffolding there, because everything's changed and it's taking a while for me to get used to stuff, you know. So yeah, basically it was overcomplicated for no benefit. No. I don't want to do that. I want that. So that's what's in the blocks. What's in the chest? Nothing. So where did the composters go? Are they in the other one, which is to the left? No. So where the hell do the composters end up? Didn't pick them up. And why have I got one? Oh yeah, that's because of that. So there are composters lost in the system somewhere. We'll sort this out in a bit. Something's jammed again. Composters. They didn't actually go into a composter themselves, did they? It might have done, because that looks like it's... no, it's empty. They're not hiding around here. So where do they go? Where are my composters? Anyway, while that is doing that, we will come back to that. We'll take a look at an automatic kelp farm, of which I have four, which I think is pretty much should be a target for early game, as early in the game as you can get it, really. And this is one of them. You can see we've got a section of kelp growing away, some pistons and some observers. There you go. It goes up and down. The observers trigger the pistons, which obviously trigger everything off. But the key thing is this water here, which drives everything down to this section of fence. The key to getting the water to do this is to place and break blocks in front of each observer, and then the water will start to flow down. As you can see, we've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. It's a 7, 1, 2, 3, 4. Is it 7 or 8? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Yeah, it's 8. So it's covering the full length of the water flow. So as you place and break blocks underneath each, then the blocks of water will flow. So kelp will naturally float up to the top after it's broken, and then get carried away, drop down here when it reaches the end, and then get carried away into the system. And I have four of these. One of these things is difficult to make early game, and I think it's the observer. The pistons are nothing special. But the glass is obviously difficult early game. In order so you can see what's going on, and seeing what's going on is pretty important, because you need, there it goes, you need to see what's going on with the water flow, and if any kelp is getting is hanging around the bottom or something like that. Yeah, because kelp is now the main fuel source, hence very important early game. Coal is now limited to certain areas. You're not going to get it while you're mining for diamonds or redstone. It's got to be further up now. There is that stop, that's now caught up with itself. Great. So that's still there. There's nothing there. Where did those composters go? That's what I want to know. I don't have another composter. It would have come under mega blocks. They're there. Let's put the scaffold away. So yeah, hopefully that should also be a bit of a benefit to the frames per second, of which we're sort of getting a reasonable one. It's gone up a few FPS, I think. And we are now going to speed furnace. As you can see, it's the main fuel for the speed furnace. The trick is, it takes manual intervention. For an 8 furnace, speed furnace, that's 8 blocks of kelp, each block doing 20. That gives you a total of 160, and 160 is 2.5 stacks of anything. So if you put 2.5 stacks in, you're making full use of a full block of kelp for burning. But obviously you've got to process the kelp, which means you've got to cook it first. So that's 2, 2.5. In other words, it's 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And we've got 2.5 there. So that'll take, that will use full blocks. So we chuck that in, and that should now go direct to the speed furnace after we've been messing about with it. And everything is now running and cooking kelp. Where the heck? That also tells me that the composters, wherever they are, did not go into there. So what happened to the composters? There is still something jamming the machine, so we will unjam it again. I have tried putting a timer on there in order to control the pulse of things going through, to make sure things went through on a reasonable pulse, but that didn't happen. Things still jammed up, so who knows what's going on. I got no clue what's happening there now. Oh, you can mew. Things are still jamming it, and there's no easy way out of that. So I can't trust the ejection, the auto burn system. I've got to check what's in there before I let it auto burn anything. So that's now doing the dried kelp, and when the dried kelp comes in, we just chuck it in, put it into. That should be processing a lot more dried kelp than it is. Is there a jam somewhere? You see, this is pretty much one of the things that I've been doing a lot of lately. Where is it going? Because it's not ending up in the dried kelp, or is it just delayed? What the hell is going on? I'm going to need some scaffold again. Oh, the joys of this game. Figuring out what's going on. So stuff is definitely going up. It's ending up in these chests. Let's get up there. How do I get up there? The stairs. The stairs should actually put us very close to that, so we're at risk of picking anything up. Dried kelp was going through there, seen going through there. Not going through there. Shit. Okay, let's stop the machine and fix this problem. Everything's been going through there. That is the dried kelp block, which we need. In fact, we're probably going to need a couple of them. Bugger. The programming must have gone west after I did it. Which means we need to get down this way. I'm picking stuff up from the column of water. What's the pattern? Should be 41. One of that. One, a cookie monster must have come in. Okay, we'll let the thing rip again. Okay, somehow a cookie monster must have gone into the system and wrecked it. Which would explain where a lot of stuff is. So now that this is repaired, I've now got to feed stuff back in again and get access to the chest to sort it all out. Dried kelp, feather, cookie monster cookie needs to be put away safe. And let's get in the back and see what's going on. Oh crap. There they are. The one thing we can't easily get at is that one under there. Oh yes, we can. Ooh, more Cookie Monster cookies. That's not good. Okay. So that's the machine sorted out again. Let's put these sodding Cookie Monster cookies away. I should have done that more sensibly. That's my fault. This explains where they went. And we got some of that. And we got some of that. We got some of that. What else have we got? White concrete, which won't go into the system. The rest of it should. That. Bum 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 bum. Right. I should have taken the cookies out manually before I did anything, and concrete is now there. And we don't need scaffolding. So hopefully everything should now work, and we should be getting bright kelp in here, and we are. Bingo! Bonus! So pretty much that's the maths. So long as you put a multiple of 2.5 stacks in there, the speed furnace should be perfectly happy. It should use an entire block of dried kelp. It does need processing. Once you've got to cook the kelp to dried kelp, then you've got to craft it into dried kelp blocks, but it seems to be the only reliable source of ongoing fuel that you can make automatically. And eventually, it just made sense to get rid of some of the extra stuff and turn the entire system over to dried kelp blocks. I took the other thing up. That's now done. A few other things have been going on. In fact, I'll probably try and do a recording of this. It's night at the moment, so I'll take you on a quick walk. We're not carrying anything underway yet. We're clear. As you know, that section is all working now, as it was before. This section is deserted because we pretty much killed off all the beds out of all the buildings, and I destroyed all the villages. Murdered them mercilessly. So all of this lot has now got to be cleared. And all of the thingy watsits have gone as well. Basically, this lot was left as zero. In order for spawning creatures to come in and do battle with the golems, and there are no more iron golems around. So that has done its job. Oh crap! There we go. Come on in. You want a piece of me? Come on. Got him. Coming for a second run? No. Ah. Chicken. Got caught up on the roof. Ah. Come on. Can get some. One more and it'll be done, I think. You're done. You are done, dusted, and over. So a lot of this stuff has now got to be taken up and destroyed. And taken back to grass. Except for one building, which was here, and that has now been moved. That building has been moved because I wanted to keep it. It was a good one. It was a nice one. So I've moved that building over here in place of an old one. So that should be all right. And everybody's sleeping. Actually, this building had more beds in it, so they have grown a few young ones, I think. Oh yeah, pretty much most of the beds are now occupied. I have seen some young villagers running around. So who knows what's happened to that. But one of the things that I'm... Yep, that's working. We also have blue fire, by the way. I'll come back to that in a minute. What am I doing? Too much to show you guys. I did some more in the Nether, basically. Brian wanted some soul soil to make some blue thingy what's it, and he also wanted some lights. So what I did is here, I brought back some netherrack and made a section of land. Brought in one of each, and then the soil, the whatever the soil you call it, I haven't got any of it in here, will just do as it does. It doesn't do it on its own. You have to force it. And I've got four extra pumpkins in here. These are what grow. So your bone meal, everything. That's why I must have taken those out of my hands. You bone meal everything, and you get various mushrooms and stuff growing. And these trees do not respect limits. Whereas the overland trees do respect. If they've got something above them, they will not grow into that space. That's not the case for these. So if you once you get the mushrooms, you have to make sure that they are within this radius, because they will grow up to 28 or 29 high, and up to 9 wide. I'll just move that one in. And they will not respect blocks, they will destroy blocks. So good luck with that. So we can just do this and that, and we have to bone meal them. They will not go up automatically over time. You got to bone meal them. Occasionally they will deal you some damage because they'll push you into the ground. They will happily grow into each other. They've got a certain chance of growing massively high. Oop, like that. So you just got to get out from under it. And that is one lot done. As you can see, you've got pretty much everything you need. You've got the wood, you've got the shroom lights and everything there. So we'll just do the same here. We've got some of the other ones as well. We'll just gather up these and put them inside the boundary. Oh, that's... I must have missed that with the bone mealing, and we need more bone meal. And we need more bone meal anyway, so we'll come back and do that. They're all now within the... apart from those two, they're not. So we'll just place those within the limits. Neither is that one. We'll get a load more bone meal. I'll bone mill those up. Oops. Come on. Just bone mill that. Oh. Come on. Don't waste my bone meal. Oh, that happened again. Yeah, these do not grow over time. You've got to bone meal things, which is a real pain. They're all grown. Any big ones? Nope. So yeah, hence you've got to grow them within that section, otherwise they will quite happily they won't actually destroy the blocks, but they will go through them, so it's possible to end up with a tree growing through the wall. Now these are mostly 5x5, I think, but yeah, they could end up 9x9 according to some wikis that I read. So that's not good, but at least we've managed to... that was the old village, by the way, which is now that. So yeah, that's done for that. The other thing that I did do, and it's in the nether, I'll take you there now, is... after I've put these organics away... organics up there, which is those and those. We have lights, we're not going to need any more, but what the heck. We've got some wood blocks, we've got some wooden fences to put away, and we have some phantom that is now away as well, and there's more stuff stuck. Great, we'll deal with that when we come back. So the blue light, you end up with that. Oh, I'll show you. I shall show you. There are a few things. So we ended up with some solar soil in the end, but light. Soul torches. And that is actually the standard torch, but with the addition of some soul sand or soul soil, from which you can make the soul lantern, and then you have the soul campfire, which you can also make using the same thing, and we now have both soul soil and soul sand. So that's that. The soul soil was an interesting one, because at the start we thought that only the soul soil would work. Took a bit, but eventually we worked out that the soul sand would do just as well. So I'm going to show you some of what I did, because yeah, this is why I used the emergency armor. Dyne map helped, because it shows what's around you, so you can do a bit of adventuring and see where you're going, and then all you need to do is plan how to get there. Those plans are not always straightforward. Come on. There's a few other things with this new Zoglin, or whatever the hell they've called it. This really, really angry zombie pig. Hog, rather than pig. Apparently those green mushrooms that you saw me handling earlier on, it's supposed to stay away by up to like 7 blocks away from one of those. So in theory, as long as what I've read right, you can use one of those to sort of protect yourself if there's one of those around. But obviously you're gonna need a few. yeah. So I managed to make a little base, and I'm also recording this so that Brian knows where it is, if he needs it, which is down here. And this is something that we're going to... I've located another mansion. And one of the things I want to do is go and take another mansion apart. An awful lot of wood comes out of one of those. But it's just for the fun of doing it, really, the battle. But hey-ho. So we're going to need that. Our netherite pickaxe. How long have we been recording for? 40 minutes. Oh, quite a bit then. Whoops. I took that out as well. What did I take out? Cobblestone from where? Probably there. Anyway, that's that back. So yeah, made myself a small little base and did some bridge building. Not easy. Helped in small part because, well, I'll show you. You can see we've got some soul sand around here, but I don't want to dig anything up around here because it's dangerous. I'd rather dig it up somewhere safe that I know where I am, rather than dig it out of a tunnel and potentially leave myself a massive great big hole or get my tunnel flooded with lava. So yeah, I'd rather do it this way. Shall we do it this way? Oh, what the hell? Haha! There's a zombie pig man on a thingy, what's it? And it's trying to steer it and the thing's having none of it. Nice try. Not gonna work. No, we'll use the tunnel. Where am I going? Tunnel. Tunnel, tunnel, tunnel. What the hell was I saying before we saw that? Yeah, or before we get lava, just flood a tunnel and like that, and then we got hell to play. Got an awful mess to deal with, so it's easier to go to a safe spot and just decimate that instead. So, at the other end of the tunnel are some torches which lead to a small cabin that I created with some carpet on the floor. And hopefully that's doing its job. I haven't seen anything spawn in there yet, but hey-ho. It's the first time for everything. It's all a matter of odds. There is a mod that Brian has got, and hopefully I'll be able to add it into this at some point, which will show the areas where mobs can spawn. Very handy for lighting, but not very handy for anything else, I don't think. Well, I'm not sure. It'll be, because it's always interesting when you place a block down to know whether or not a mob can actually spawn on top of it or not. And the other interesting thing is I've never seen anything spawn down in the cavern that I've dug out for the thingy. What's it? This would be a first time if there is anything. No, there's nothing down here. Nothing down here. No zombie pigmen. No, nothing. What gives? What's over there? No, nothing. Not a squashage. So we're going to carry on up. And we have a number of torches that we can follow. Oops. Oh yeah, that's where I got slammed. I got shot at. And as you can see, I've put some mushrooms around here to hopefully keep the hog thingies out, including one there. One there. I think I've got a couple around the back. But as you can see, it quickly turns into nether wastes. So, currently we're in Warped Forest. Nothing down here. And it very quickly turns into a nether waste. So we're still in Warped Forest there. So we've got a simple base. And we've got access to all our ender stuff there. I've left some cooked chicken and stuff. Came across a few skeletons. And a load of netherrack and cobblestone to build with. Nothing in the furnace. I've got no material to furnace with down here. But pretty much started building this to the north. Oh, there's a small zombie pigman, because we're now... it's very similar to the nether waste war forest. Right at the start of that, it changes into nether waste, which helps immensely. And can we see one of those zombie thingy, piggy wiggies? Zoglins, or whatever the hell they call them. I don't think we can from here. But they are in there, and they're more prevalent in the red one, I think. What's that? Nope, that's a zombie piglin. Yeah. So I came as far as there, and then had to divert. Because what I diverted around was that. It would have been interesting to try and go through it, but I don't think I would have succeeded somehow. Or it would have taken a lot of effort. Something's on top of the roof, probably. They do that. So yeah, came through here. Another few interesting areas, which are now pretty much mostly black, because there was some nice, easy to get glowstone over there, so I got it. As you can see, I got shot at a few times. Yep. I was making this a double all the way. I'm not sure why I actually made this a double. I think it was a hangover from the bridges that I was making. I have taken some stuff out of here. Typically, if I'm running low on something or need to recharge something, then I will go for these, for the points to recharge whatever it is that needs recharging. And I came to this point and then hit some soil and some soul sand, and I thought, okay, what to do. So I decided to go up, and I hit a nether fortress, and then I just continued up, and the screaming is there, so we're going to get shot at some point, so you can see all the blue fire. I've just taken a load of soil and stuff and did a runner. Oh, shit. You're dead. The other great thing about this is that these caverns are so closed in that, yeah. There's bones over there. Where did you come from? I don't know. I don't care. You're dead. You're dead to me. They're so closed in that you can actually get the thingy, what's it now? That's interesting. I would have expected the recipe thing to say there's new recipes. Ow. Oh shit, there it is, over there. We've got some bone, let's get out of here. Yeah, it is a dangerous area. It is a dangerous area. Especially with the soul sand slowing you down. You have problems. Goes... Where does it go? One of them ends in dead end. Which is... Not this one. Yeah. It was sort of generated like that, and I haven't adventured down there yet. But it's going to be interesting when we do. I've already robbed these chests. So yeah, we have another ghost here. Because previously, with the nether wastes, as they were, the ghasts would just spawn in. Let's just get rid of this. While we're carting a few things around. And when you actually, they were so far away you couldn't hit them with a sword. You had to use bow and arrow, and when you did that they were inevitably over lava, so when they dropped the ghast tier, it would just get totaled. But this time we've actually got, they're actually reachable, and they're over land. in these new biomes, which is pretty impressive. So now we have bone block. Do you make bone from bone block? We can make bone meal from that. I don't know. I must have hit bone block somewhere before. Yeah. Where am I going? Oh, yeah. Forget my own things. There they are, a few of them are down there. No very angry pigs down there to see yet. Yeah, let's just be a bit careful. So yeah, we will head for home. Because one of the things that I've got to do is demolition duty. And I want to try a speed up during the demolition and merge that into the video. There's a lot of buildings to take down, and so I'm going to try that. Try a little speed up, because a number of people have commented. And it is nice to be able to bring a cinematic view to the gameplay, especially when it's long, boring stuff. It's just a shame that I didn't really have the guts to venture with the replay mod when I was originally building the castle, the Chateau de Survival. But hey ho. It's also interesting seeing what Brian is doing, particularly with his base, and how he is adding shape and texture into it. It's a bit sad that I can't really do that with the blocks that I'm using, which is the terracotta. They haven't made half terracotta blocks yet, or terracotta stairs, or anything like that yet. Which would be great if they did, or at least not the coloured, the glazed terracotta, you know, the one with a pattern on it. Real shame they haven't done that yet, but it's probably a bit hard to put patterns on some of the stuff like the half blocks. Yeah, I actually came up here once and found a ghast right there, so I was able to kill it quite easily. And there's some glowstone there. Not quite so easy to get, but if I need it, I can do that. That's not a problem. It's not as easy pickings as some of the others have been. As you can see, the cobblestone up there. There was some glowstone up there, and I nabbed it. So yeah, it's been interesting. The other interesting thing is going to be doing, hopefully if it's successful, doing a replay, destroying something, as opposed to building something. Everyone else seems to use the replay mod when they're building something, and I'm going to be using it when I'm taking a load of buildings down. I've also restricted the area that the foxes are in. Let's just get that out of my hands easily. Put that there. And I'm going to use the opportunity to give you more of a view of the outside of the chateau. Because it's pretty impressive, really. The chateau itself was inspiration mostly from Dragon Palace by Gemini Tay. It was Gemini Tay, I think. The Prismarine Tunnel was from, I think, an episode in Hermitcraft, I think. I've seen what other people, including Brian J, have done to their base, and done a few things. I mean, those vines actually work quite well, because I've tried to place a door there previously. I can't get away from the white concrete, because it is the outside of the tower, outside of the chateau. So, you know, I can't replace the white concrete, but at the same time, making a sort of curved door-esque thing between the white and the black, it has not been easy. So being able to hang those vines is just pretty much a godsend for that. It solved the problem of covering off the area while not making it look really weird. And we're back. Yep, it closed. So yeah, as you can see, a load of beech in order to do that dug down section that I did down there. It took quite a bit to kill things off, but without actually getting a bad reputation. That was the trick. Killing things without getting a bad reputation from it. While we're on the stairs, we'll just nip up and see what's jammed the system again. Well, this hasn't jammed the system. We can actually access it from down here. Yep, I'll put those back in the system. I'll put bone in organics for now, because I don't think we're actually going to get that much of it. Indeed, if we can craft bone. If we have bones, can we actually craft a block of bone? Or if we have a block of bone, can we uncompress it? No, it doesn't look like we can. So let's get the soul soil and soul sand away. Can we actually make a block of bone? Where is bone? Bone's there. And we haven't got that much of it. No, we can't craft a block of bone either, which is interesting. Arrows, we're going to have to put in the machine because there's a lot of them. That can go in the machine as well. Bone, we'll put in organics for now. Ghast tier is in the specialist chest. Like that, along with the brick, nautilus shells. Heart of the sea, yada yada blah. And we're going to destroy a section, which means we're going to need earth. We're probably going to need a chunk of earth. We're probably going to need a few shulker boxes. And we're probably going to need some more light. Going to need some more torches, I think. How often we're going to need them for it? Oh, there's something else stuck in there again. Oh, I can stay there for a while. Is there anything else that we're going to need? We have axe for the wood, pick. Yes, we're going to need a silk touch pick. I'm going to swap that out for the silk touch pick so I can pick up the glass. Because there's a fair chunk of glass. We also may need some scaffolding. Shouldn't need much. We shall see. Is that going to be enough? No, we'll take some more shulker boxes. And it is midday, but it's probably not going to be long before it's night. And we're going to have some more phantoms to deal with.
Yeah.
Great. So I'm going to start here. And, yeah. So let's start the recording and see where we go. Start recording. Haha. I know. This isn't the speeded up footage that you were expecting to see. To cut a long story short, Brian J let me know that if there wasn't enough memory available to Minecraft, then there was a chance that Replay Mod could fail. But you wouldn't find out until you'd finished the session, and then Replay Mod would set about recording everything or dumping everything to disk, and then Minecraft would helpfully tell you that it had run out of memory. Which is exactly what happened with this first section. I was being cautious, and you may notice the occasional join in later footage where I decided to chop things up a little bit to make sure that there was enough there. And indeed, after the first lot of footage was lost, I increased the total memory available to Minecraft to 12 gig. So we'll see how that runs. Unfortunately, there's no real way to work out what's going to fail until it's failed. And on a survival server, that does mean that if footage is lost, then it's lost. It's not possible really to refilm it unless the server itself is wound back to a previous point in time, and then the efforts are remade, so to speak. Fortunately, as this was my first attempt at a recording of reasonable length, I did have the in-camera recorder still running, so I do have footage to show you, and that's what you're seeing. And after the adjustments, there is some footage coming up after this lot. So if you do stick with it, then there is some better footage coming. Unfortunately, I can't repeat the work that I've done in this segment. That's the case with many mods. You've got to take them as they come and learn how to use them and what their limits are. And unfortunately, when you're playing a survival game, you can't replay stuff. You've basically just got to do it then and there. And if it all fluffs up, then it's a learning experience and you've lost footage. That's the name of the game, unfortunately. Well, the name of the game is Minecraft, but hey-ho. Yeah, so, unfortunately, it is the way it is. Not much I can do about it, and I just deem myself very fortunate to have been still running the other recording system while I was running the Replay Mod recording. So at least I do have something to show you. So yeah, where do I go from here? Basically, I've just got to leave you at the mercy of the recording, I suppose. And a few more minutes in, it will change. And you should get some better footage of some of the battles, some of the later battles, with the whatever the heck they call them, the flying thingies. Okay, my memory, I tell you, my memory is good. But when I need it to remember something, I can't. But it'll come to me later. They're not ghouls, they're not ghasts, they are striders? No, I've forgotten what the heck they're called. But those flying thingies. You'll see them further on. So for now, I'll leave you with a little music to enjoy the footage that's going ahead. And see you later. And apologies for having lost this footage. See you later. Ciao for now.